Hello friends, welcome to Engineering Funda family. In this video, I'm going to explain you Booth's algorithm along with its flowchart and its circuit. In my previous video, I have solved two examples based on Booth's algorithm. At that time, I have told you, before you learn how to draw flowchart and how to make circuit of Booth's algorithm, you should practice one or two examples at least. And based on that, you can easily make flowchart and circuit. So first, let me show you how we have seen those examples. Based on that, I'll explain you first how we can have flowchart, right? So if you see, we have solved two problems. This is one problem and this is second problem, right? I wish you will be watching those two videos first. And once you see that, you can easily make flowchart. So see, when you want to draw flowchart or Booth's algorithm, first of all, you will have to initialize the process, right? So when you want to initialize the process, you will have to see what are the datas that we need to give as input. So if you observe here, accumulator, that will be initially zero. Then multiplier, so you see 4 and 6 that we want to multiply, where 4 is multiplier. So 4 that I have written over here as per 0, 1, 0, 0. And this data that I need to represent along with sign. So plus 4 means 0, 1, 0, 0. Where this initial zero that is there with plus sign, right? And then we need to initialize with q minus 1 is equals to 0, and multiplicand, that is 6 over here. With multiplicand, we should be having two different values. One is positive multiplicand and second is negative multiplicand, right? And then we need to execute steps. So you see here, I have executed 4 steps, right? You see, I have executed 4 steps. Why I have executed 4 steps? The reason is number of steps that is there based on how many bits that we multiply. If you see, multiplier and multiplicand both are having size of 4 bits. That's why we need to have 4 steps. So let us try to understand first how exactly we need to initialize the flowchart, right? So in Booth's algorithm, first of all, we need to have start of this flowchart. Then you see accumulator, that is initially 0. Then q minus 1, that should be initially 0, multiplier that we need to place, and count n that I am loading over here. Count n explains what, how many steps that we need to execute, right? So that is what initialization which we have done over here. Now we need to execute these steps. So how to execute these steps? So that even I have explained you. See here, q 0 and q minus 1, that will define what are the operations that we need to do over here, right? Let me tell you what are those operations. See, as if q0 and q minus 1, that is 00 or 11, then you don't need to perform any arithmetic operation. Simply, you will have to do shift right operation. And shift right operation, that is compulsory. Like you see here, q0, q minus 1, that is 00. So simply, we have performed shift right operation. So this data that we have shifted towards right side, and this shift right operation, that is arithmetic shift. Arithmetic shift means what? Arithmetic shift means first bit that should be as it is, then you will have to shift right. Normal shift operation, that is what? In normal shift operation, we will be keeping first bit as 0 and then you will be providing shift. But here you don't need to provide normal shift operation. Here you will have to provide arithmetic shift operation, in which first MSB, that will be as it is, and then you'll have to provide one bit shift right operation, right? So as if q0, q1, that is 00 or 11, then no arithmetic operation, direct shift right operation that you need to perform. And you see, as if q0, q minus 1, as if it is 10, then you'll have to perform subtract m with accumulator. And as if q0, q minus 1, that is 01, then you'll have to perform add M, right, with accumulator. So that is how steps that we need to follow. Let me show you how we can have that in flowchart. So we will be checking, Q0, Q minus 1. As if Q0, Q minus 1, that is 00 or 11, then direct shift right that we need to do. And shift right, that we'll be doing it for what? Shift right, that will be doing 4, you see that will be doing 4, this accumulator, this multiplier, and this q minus 1, right? So here that shift right, that will be doing 4 accumulator, this q, and this q minus 1. But what if q0, q minus 1, that is 0, 1 and 1, 0. So you see, as if q0, q minus 1, that is 1, 0, we will be performing subtract m operation, right? So we'll be modifying the content of accumulator by subtract m, right? So let me show you that as if it is 1, 0. So here, as if q0, q minus 1, that is 1, 0, that accumulator content, that will be as per accumulator minus m, right? Subtract m. And as if q0, q minus 1, that is 0, 1, accumulator content, that will get modified as per addition of m with accumulator. And then you will have to perform shift right operation of a, q, q minus 1, right? So that is how we perform steps. After execution of all these steps, what we need to do? We need to decrement the count. Count explains what, how many steps that we need to execute. So here, after that, you will be decrementing the value of that count, and you will be checking count, right? As if C is not equals to 0, what you will be doing? You will be repeating this, and as if C is equals to 0, then you will be ending the algorithm, and your answer will be there inside accumulator and Q. That will be the multiplication of Q and N, right? And for that, I have already explained you the basic examples, right? So I think now, based on this flowchart, you can understand how exactly we do the process, right? First, you will have to initialize the data. Accumulator should be 0 initially. Q minus 1 should be 0 initially. Then multiplier that you need to place in table. Then count will be there based on number of bits. Then you'll have to do the steps as per number of count. Means number of steps is equals to number of count. Then you'll have to execute the steps. That is there based on value of Q0 and Q minus 1. If it is 0, 0 or 1, 1, don't do any arithmetic operation. Just shift right operation that we need to do. If it is 0, 1, add M with accumulator and modify the content of A. As if Q0, Q minus 1, that is 1, 0, subtract M and then modify the value of A. See, this is how we need to repeat this for how many times? Number of count times, right? So here I have written C, but it should be N over here as I have considered the variable as N, right? Now, my dear students, let me show you how circuit can be there. As if you want to make circuit, then simply, you see, we will be performing addition and subtraction operation. So let us say this arithmetic operation, that could be addition or subtraction, right? Obviously, one input that is coming from accumulator. So here, you will be having accumulator, right? That is A. And that shifting is happening with Q. Q is multiplier. So let me write multiplier over here, that is Q. And what we add or subtract over here? Multiplicand. So here we'll be having multiplicand, and that is M, right? Now you see XOR gate that I'm using. XOR gate is having property which explains what? Which explains you, as if input provided from here is 0. If input provided from here is 0, right, if C is equals to 0 over here, let us say C is 0 over here, in that situation, here you will be having M over here. But as if C is equals to 1 over here, then you'll be having that M bar over here, right? So let me show you two conditions. As if C is equals to 0 over here, then here you'll be having M. So here you'll be having C is equals to 0. So this accumulator A, that will be addition of accumulator A plus M, right? But as if you have C is equals to 1 over here, right? Control signal is equals to 1. Then XOR gate, that will gives you M bar over here. And here C is equals to 1. So your accumulator, that will be A plus M bar plus 1. You see this C is equals to 1 that we need to add, right? And A plus M bar plus 1, that is what? That is subtraction, right? So this control unit this control unit that will define whether to have C is equals to 0 or C is equals to 1. And that control unit will define C is equals to 0 or 1 based on what? Based on value of Q is equal to Q0, Q minus 1, right? I have already told you, you see initially Q0, Q minus 1 that we are having, and that is getting upgraded based on shifting operation. So here you see shifting operation is happening, and that Q is connected with this control unit. So control unit will generate C is equals to 0 or 1 based on the value which is there with Q0, Q minus 1, right? So this is how complete circuit is there. I hope it is clear to you. Still, if anything that would like to share it with me, note it down in comment box. I'll be happy to help you. Thank you so much for watching this video.